Do a quick reminder, we've had a pretty dry summer here in California. Hadn't had a lot of rain, so the ground's been very dry. It's middle of January, and we've had like one rain. And I see people watering their grass because it hasn't been raining, and watering their trees, saying they're, they need to be watered because we've had such a light water. But I don't know if people think about a horse's hooves, and which is another reason I like to have my water dripping or have a little mud around a water hole. So when a horse goes and gets a drink, you notice Buddy's front foot there is kind of muddy. And Mr. T just kind of went through. He got a little, and the other horse, Lacey over there, she walked through. Putting a little water or having mud around your watering hole helps put a little moisture in those hooves. Normally in wintertime, the hooves get too much water, and that's not good if they stand in mud all the time, because then they get too soft. But they also get dried out, and they'll crack and get brittle if they don't ever go in water. And again, going back to more natural and the herd in the wild, horses in the wild, they'll walk 25 miles a day so that their feet get kind of naturally trimmed and shaved down. So they have to grow in order to keep hooves in order to find food. If their hooves didn't grow that fast, they'd wear them out looking for food. Well, same thing about when they go to get a drink of water. That they go to watering holes. They go to lakes. They go to puddles. They go down to riverbanks to get a drink. All that puts mud on their hooves. Puts a little moisture back in their hooves. So their hooves don't get dry and brittle and crack and split. And there's a lot of things that humans try to do to fix that. Like, painting those hooves with that lotion and all kind of hoof treatments and oils and conditioners and pine tar. Whatever you want to put on a horse's foot. Those are all things trying to help put moisture back in a horse's hoof. I see a lot of times people overdo that. They want to give their horse so much care, and they think if I put it on once a week, a little conditioner, if I did it every day, it would be five times as good or seven times as good. Well, that's not true. Too much human involvement is not good. The natural way is best. And normally, horses' hooves would get muddy or wet when they went and got a drink in the wild. And then they would walk out of the mud, and they would go walk and dry, or they would go stand in a dry, and they would walk, and they would go look for food, etc. So don't forget your horse's hooves. If you don't have any mud out there, if you're in an area that's been very dry, same in the summer. It's just now it's kind of wintertime here in California. Of course, it's 68 degrees, and we've gotten no rain. But the horse's hooves need water just like your grass and your trees, etc. They need a little mud. They need a little moisture every once in a while. So, and again, in my other videos, I talk about draining your waters, having little mud holes around your water. It helps the horses get a natural moisture when they go and get a drink. And you're not going to see any horse just standing out there in mud unless it gets really hot. Then it helps cool them down. So just a little reminder on the horse's hooves, mud, moisture, and water for your horse's hooves. In the wintertime, I like doing my horse's feet because they're usually easier because they're standing in the rain and it makes them softer. So I don't have to file as hard, and it's a lot easier to file them down and do them. Usually it's wet and muddy, so I got to dry them off or put them in a dry spot. But their hooves have a lot more moisture in it, and it makes it a little bit easier to keep them trimmed down. But, again, less is more. Never try to catch up or try to do more or try to get ahead of what's natural. Small steps, slow ways, a fast way, and everything with horses. All right, hope that helps. We'll end that there. Buddy, you're a good old boy. Mr. T, good boy. Lacey, you're a good girl, too.